back. Edna.
What?
Hey, I got a hot lead for you.
Oh? What is it?
Kid Tannen arrested.
Oh, glorious day! When did it happen?
Well, it hasn't happened yet, but it's gonna.
Keep me posted.
Do you think I could have a copy of your You Should Care lyrics? I've got a club of my own that could really use some inspiring.
Sure! Let me just get a page out of the hymnal. There you are.
Hey, thanks. See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight.
Edna!
What?
You know, Trixie Trotter sings a song that sounds a lot like your You Should Care.
She does?
Yeah, but hers is a little more carefree.
That's what you get when you sing for booze hounds and gangsters.
See ya.
Keep fighting the good fight.
Testing, testing. Sibilance, sibilance.
Hey, quit playing with my equipment.
Sorry. Hey, boy, how you doing? Good dog. Hey, boy, take a whiff of this. Gotta love that nose.
I've been laying low, officer, but I've gotta go to the pictures once in a while.
Hello, Arthur.
Officer?
I'll take it from here.
But...
We can talk at the Majestic, away from prying eyes.
Yeah, Einstein, you done good. So, Emmett's gonna get his big idea while watching Frankenstein, huh? I guess that explains a lot about Doc. Hey, Doc, I could use a little help.
What's the problem?
Is Artie still here?
He's in the bathroom.
Hey, Artie, open up. You've got a gangster to bring down.
Is it time for me to meet this Sylvia?
No, it's time for you to meet Trixie.
Trixie says she's got something that might be able to send Kid up the river, but that you're the only one she trusts to check it out.
Me? What is she... Oh, I know what she's done. Clever.
Care to let us in on the secret?
Sorry, guys, but if Trixie's keeping it a secret, then so am I.
That's all well and good, Mr. McFly, but if you and Trixie are going to collaborate on this evidence, we'll need to arrange a rendezvous.
Well, Trixie's chained to Kid's speakeasy.
So we'll have to bring Arthur to Trixie.
Uh-uh. No way am I getting anywhere near that place again. I don't know how you talked me into this.
Just stay back here in the shadows, and don't come out until you see Trixie.
You're sure I'll be safe here?
Perfectly safe. We'd never make you take any unnecessary...
Sagan. Where's Kid?
Don't worry.
Is Trixie on her way?
Welcome back, sir.
What's it gonna take to get Trixie to squeal on Kid? Hey, Trixie, look over there!
Why?
Didn't you see it?
No.
Ah, never mind. Trixie?
Yeah?
Guess who's waiting in the alley to talk with you?
Huddy?
The one and only. It wasn't easy to track him down. I had
to... Cover for me, Q-Ball. I'm taking a smoke break.
Atta girl.
Hey, you!
Huh?
Yeah, jerk. I saw you making eyes at my Eunice.
Sorry, pal. I don't have time for a fight.
Why, you... I'll never get to Carnegie Hall at this rate. All right, fella. I think you're done for the night. Hey, where do you think you're going?
Me?
Yeah, you. What do you know about this?
Nothing. I...
Ah! Trixie?
Break's over, Q-Ball.
Whatever you say, babe.
What was that? Trixie?
Yeah?
What happened in the alley with Arthur?
I don't want to talk about it.
What about your insurance policy?
There ain't no insurance policy. After tonight, I'm tossing it in the furnace and burning it up.
Come on, Trixie, can't you tell me what happened out there?
No!
Then at least give me the evidence you got on Kid.
No, I made a deal with myself. As soon as tonight's set is over, the evidence goes up in smoke.
Break a leg out there.
Thanks.
You Should Care. Much better song for her. Hey!
Take a hike, Squirt.
Artie?
You missed a hell of a party, buddy.
Kid, well, what happened?
Oh, you're gonna love this. So, I'm hanging out in the club when all of a sudden I get an urge to drain the lizard, right? I come out into the alley, and who do I see? None other than that scrawny, subpoena-answering rat, Artie McFly. And get this! The little worm's whispering away all conquistadorial-like with my Trixie!
Oh, no.
Naturally, I pull out Kid Jr. and prepare to put a couple bullets in McFly's head. Which causes Artie's nose to start bleeding because he's a big wuss. And then...
What?
Trixie literally gets down on the knees and begs me to let him live!
Huh?
Seriously, down on the knees crying and begging for McFly's life!
So, what did you do?
What could I do? I fired two shots in the air and told Artie to take a hike.
Huh, that was merciful.
Hey, I got plenty of mercy. Besides, now Trixie owes me big time. And Kid Tannen always collects on his debts. Always.
Welcome back, sir.
Voila!
Nice job.
Now, go tell them chumps at the New Yorker.
Man, that really looks a lot like my dad. And my granddad. Sorry about this, Dad. Trixie?
Yeah?
I talked to Kid.
Oh?
He told me about Artie.
Oh.
It was awesome of you to plead for his life.
And it was awesome of Kid to spare it. So you see why I gotta get rid of all the dirt I got on Kid. As long as he's loyal to me, I gotta stay loyal to him.
Okay, so Kid spared Artie's life, but that doesn't make him a saint.
Believe me, no one knows that better than me. But if Kid can let Artie off the hook, I guess I can let him off the hook. Know what I mean?
About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
I think something bad might have happened to him.
What? You mean Kid went back on his promise?
Yeah, that's right.
Oh no! Oh, poor Artie! Poor sweet little Artie!
I know.
That rattlesnake Kid! He can't get away with this!
You gonna turn over the evidence you got against him?
Am I ever? Just watch me! Wait a minute. What evidence do you have that Kid bumped Artie off?
It's just a hunch.
Keep your hunches for the racetrack. It ain't nice to get a girl all worked up over unsubstantiated rumors.
About Artie McFly.
What about him? Have you heard from him? Is he okay?
Oh, yeah, he's okay.
Are you sure?
Believe me, if he wasn't okay, I'd be the first to know. I don't know how to tell you this, but I think you should check out the Wall of Fame.
Why? What is it? Artie! I don't believe it! We had a deal! Artie was supposed to be safe!
I don't know what to say.
Well, I do. Felony tax evasion.
What?
Before he died, Artie was teaching me about all sorts of stuff. Literature, history, accounting. And I made a big discovery while I was copying all of Kid's books. This establishment ain't entirely on the up and up.
Really?
Oh, I knew about all the gangster stuff. That kind of thing you expect from tough guys like Kid. But when I found out he ain't been paying taxes on his speakeasy profits, well, cheating Uncle Sam is one step over the line. Once I turn this over to the police, they'll throw the book at him. This book! Hey, copper! He's not interested. Figures. Half the police force is in Tannen's pocket.
Give me a few minutes to work on him. I've got a hunch he'll come around.
Boss?
Do you mind? I'm trying to have a good time here.
I think you'll want to see this.
Are you crazy? Bringing a stick of dynamite into my club?
That's just it, boss. It's all over the place. I think our speakeasy arsonist is getting ready to strike again.
You in?
I'm gonna play 7, 23, and 30. I wonder where this leads.
Welcome back, sir.
Looks like Parker's still parked. Bucktooth Langley. Bit off more than he could chew. Chuckles Lenart. He didn't get the last laugh. Not a pretty bunch.
should care. You should care what people think of you.
She's right. I can turn my life around.
Sure you can.
You know what? I used to be a good cop. And yeah, I've had a few bad breaks. Possibly even a psychotic one that caused me to imagine a disappearing space car. But I'm a good man.
Yeah.
And all I need to do to win Betty back is be the same good man I always was. And let the chips fall where they may.
All right.
Hey, Miss Trotter, you wanted to speak with me?
To my louse of an ex-boyfriend.
I don't know.
Rats. I told the chief we need a team of bloodhounds like they got over in Placerville. Yeah, but in the meantime... All right, everyone. Party's over. Everyone out of the speakeasy.
Speakeasy?
You're mistaken, officer. This is an ice cream parlor.
Nice try, you. Out!
Corleone. Would the Valenti mob be willing to help, defuse this little situation?
Sure, no problem. I'll bring it up in the next, company meeting.
Hey, we ain't begging here. Kid just thought JJ might like a piece of the action. Especially now that he's just caught the speakeasy arsonist.
Wait, you mean... Doc?
Doc? You ain't with the Valenti gang at all, are you? What do you know about the arsonist?
Come on, you. Off to the station house.
Kid's gonna get you, rat. He's gonna get all of you.
Yeah, yeah. Well, that's that. Thanks to Miss Trotter's evidence, the entire Hill Valley police force is out looking for Kid and his goons.
You don't understand. We've got to find him now. He's captured a friend of mine.
Who?
Never mind.
Don't worry. We've got the entire town square sealed off. If Tannen's within a mile of here, we'll find him eventually.
I don't think we have time for eventually. Irving Kid Tannen. Guess he dropped this on his way out. It's empty. Figures. Hey boy, how you doing? Good dog. Hoover 28, a chicken in every pot. How's that working out, Herbie? Hey Einie, get your nose over here. All right. I really don't think Tannen and Doc are with Herbert Hoover, Einie. Okay, I'll check it out. Button. All right, Doc. Here I come.
Corleone? What are you doing here? Never mind. Come here and help me get rid of this stinking arsonist.
Edna?
I caught her planting dynamite while he was clearing out the soup kitchen. Guess Sagan was innocent after all.
I was researching a story, you ignoramus!
Tell it to St. Peter, sister.
Hey, what's all this?
Parker?
Tannen, you're under arrest.
Get him, Sacramento boy.
I can't do that, kid.
What? Oh, I get it.
Why don't you let go of Miss Strickland and call it a night?
Hey, look over there. Watch out!
Give it up, Tannen. The alley's blocked off and so are the roads out of town. It's over.
Over? Nothing is over until Kid Tannen says it's over.
should I do?
Do you have a gun?
Not a real one.
Beats me.
He's not about to let me in.
Make it easy on yourself, Tannen.
Tannen!
Make like a tree and die, rat!
Whoa! Bowling for 10.
No one messes with Kid Tannen!
Come on, kid. You know how this'll end.
Hey, kid!
Lead, phony!
Hey, moron!
Moron, this!
Go, Tannen!
Make like a tree and die, rat! Hey!
Atta girl.
Are you shooting at me? Are you shooting at me?
So...
I'm afraid I'm finding it difficult to concentrate with all the bullets flying around my head, Mr. Corleone.
Right. In gratitude for your continued service, J.J. Valenti. You know, a cigarette lighter shaped like a gun seems like a really bad idea. Hey, kid!
That ain't a real gun!
Oh, right. I forgot. I better just get rid of it then.
Oh, crap.
Hey, he's getting away!
Oh, no.
No. There! Good as new!
Oh, look,
Tannen!
The judge's son! All right, Parker. I want a getaway car and a clear road to Nevada, or the brown kid gets it!
Doc!
Marty!
Doc?
Yes, it's me.
I'm talking to you through the radio apparatus my younger self has installed in the rocket car. What's going on up there?
It's not good, Doc. Trixie and Parker did their part, but now Kid's holding you hostage.
Right, Scott!
No kidding.
Try to get Kid in the car. Once he's inside, give me a signal, and I'll do the rest.
How am I?
You!
Emmett!
You're the cause of all of this, ain't you? You should have known. What kind of gangster's named Michael Corleone? No one makes a... Got any last words, rat? Hey!
Doc, hit it!
Irving Tannen, I'm placing you under arrest for kidnapping, attempted murder, tax evasion, and smelling like a piece of crap.
Tax evasion?
Haven't you heard? Heard? The feds are practically drooling over Trixie's books.
Trixie?
That's what you get for killing Artie, you bastard!
What? I didn't...
Trixie?
Artie?
All right, Grandpa.
My poor car.
I believe I owe you an apology, Mr. Brown. Thanks to your ridiculous contraption, Hill Valley's most notorious criminal is finally headed to prison.
No apologies necessary, Miss Strickland. My rocket car may have accidentally saved the day, but only because it's a completely out-of-control failure. I need a new idea.
If you're willing to listen, I might have a few suggestions.
But first, I think we should take in a movie.
I'm all yours, Mr. Brown.
I think you'll like it. It's all about a brilliant scientist with an overabundance of hubris.
Whew. Come on, Einie. Let's go find Doc. Thanks for letting me fly the DeLorean, Doc. This thing's a blast.
Are you absolutely sure that everything's back to normal?
Totally. Kid's going to jail, Emmett's going to see Frankenstein, and there's no such thing as a Tannen crime family in 1986. And we remembered Einstein this time, too.
Hill Valley crime rate at all-time low.
Well, except for Grandpa necking with Trixie, I think we're ready to go back to 1986.
Do you feel yourself fading out of existence?
No.
Then as long as your father's still born in 7 years, I say, let your grandfather sow his oats.
Sowing oats? Is that what's going on with you and Edna?
What are you talking about?
Emmett and Edna. They're gonna go see Frankenstein together.
That's odd. Great Scott!
What?
We've got to get back in. Oh, this could be disastrous.
Where'd you go, Doc?
Relax! We've got everything under control.
Doc?
Martin McFly, age 18.
Okay, Doc, let's see what kind of nightmare alternate timeline I've landed in this time.
Father George, Mother Lorraine.
Hill Valley under Citizen Brown is not quite the contented town you were led to believe it was.
A re-education program? What the hell?
Please don't swear, Martin. It makes me uncomfortable.
Zero demerits, until this morning.
We're through, McFly. I'll never date such a square again.
My own girlfriend thinks I'm a square?
The obvious question, Mr. McFly, is... what happened to you?
Jesus Christ, Doc, what happened to you?